Hi everyone and welcome back. So now we are starting with the APIs. Okay, we are going to write a lot of things including the API services we have. So it's like you can say the GraphQL API gateway we are going to write. This we are purely going to write in Node.js, and then we have these Nest.js services. We are going to use Node.js framework, which is Nest.js. And we are going to write at least 2 to 3 different services based on what we discussed. So this is also a Swiggy service. Let's talk about these two examples, right? So our API gateway will have a REST connector, which will talk to these services using REST endpoints. Okay. And these services will actually talk to the database. If we just talk about this particular structure here, we have Nginx. Nginx will make a forward request to our GraphQL gateway on a particular port. Like, okay, let's say this is Nginx. And for the API request, only API request, it will send to the GraphQL API gateway. Now, GraphQL API gateway can send this request to the Node.js services, respective services. Okay, I want to go to a service which is validating the authentication token. I will go to the gatekeeper service. So let's call it as a gatekeeper service. Okay, gatekeeper service. This is Swiggy service, which we are going to start writing. And this will be the REST interface. This will be the GraphQL interface. So there are a lot of things we are going to understand here. Understanding of GraphQL, understanding of the Nest.js services, the building blocks of Nest.js. I will not go into the deep of what Nest.js is and how it works. We will start writing the code. And we already have discussed about the entity models, right? What will be the Swiggy ERD will looks like, right? This is our entity relationship diagram, right? The relationships, we now have these complex relationships, but we'll try to resolve them, simplify them in terms of the ESX classes we are going to write for the entities, right? So it's like we are going to write a full-fledged application which is exposing all these APIs through the query and mutations. And we already have our front end, which already has this login registration screens and landing page. In the Next.js, we have created the base routes. Now, next thing we are going to build is starting off with the Swiggy microservices. Okay, so first microservice, we will write all the primary APIs. If you just look at this diagram, what we are actually building, this one and this one, we will just make it more synchronous. But yeah, the restaurant service, it can be independent service because it is targeting about the restaurant domains, right? Restaurant entities, what restaurants can provide, the restaurant menus, restaurant list. You can actually, there can be a restaurant admin who is just managing the restaurant information, right? Then order service. So we are not just understanding, we are not just isolating because we want a multiple microservice. But yes, we want to isolate them. So there can be a proper use case for isolating this particular service. I mean, the dependency, or we want to provide a loose coupling. And the area of in which those services are working should be totally different. It's not like they are dependent and we are somehow creating, splitting those services. Like this auth service, the objective of this auth service is just to talk to Firebase and say you yes or no for the token, if it is valid or not. This EMQP and the consumer service, which we will write in future, the only objective is to read the message from the EMQP and send it to the Azure event. Okay. So these services are in the pipeline. We'll start with the restaurant service. Okay. Restaurant service or order service, which will be the pure REST.js, pure Nest.js service exposing the REST APIs. And we'll also start spinning up this API gateway. And all these we are doing with this Docker Compose. Okay, so the next video will give you the quick overview what we are doing in the Nest.js, the Nest.js structure, modular structures, controller services and all. And then from the onwards, we will start writing the code. Okay, stay tuned guys. Thanks everyone.